2013. What can a movie be without movies, Alexis?
It was a great year in cinema. Let's leave my top 10 list and then we'll hear yours. My top 10 movie was The Lone Ranger, Johnny Depp, Army Hammer. Great movie, great pirates movie in the West. What more can you want? It's what you're getting, what you get. Not unfairly recepted, so make sure you watch that one because it was unfairly biased. Number 9, Iron Man 3, Robert Downey Jr. Come on, Iron Man. Great combination. Yes, number 8, Thor the Dark World. Loki! You gotta see Loki, come on! You gotta see Tom Hiddleston. You know all the girls wanna see there.
Thor's up all night to get Loki.
Oh my goodness. Number 7, Monsters University. Mike and Sully, come on. And the nostalgia factor. If you saw Monsters, then you gotta see this one. It's a great movie. Number 6, Captain Phillips. Tom Hanks. How can you deny Tom Hanks not watching this movie? And there was an actor in here. His name is Bakar Abdi. It was his first movie ever. And he started opposite Tom Hanks. And gotta say, he is going to get so many awards for this role. Amazing. My number 6, no, sorry, number 5, Frozen. Disney and Frozen. Songs, animation, musical. It's another great Disney princess combination. Probably the best Disney movie since The Lion King and Beauty and the Beast. The songs are way up there, so see that one. Number 4. Katniss Everdeen is Jennifer Lawrence. No, that's the other way around. Hunger Games, Catching Fire. Make sure you see that because that was so captivating. The cast is amazing and you will literally, as Kyle says, will be caught on fire. Number 3, Gravity. What are you doing on Earth? You got to go up to space. This was amazing.
If anything, this movie prevents me from wanting to go to space.
Oh, well, never mind then. Yeah, because people do crash and die. And yeah, it's kind of grim.
Spoilers.
But Sandra Bullock, great in this movie. Oscar worthy. Lee Daniels, the butler. Oprah Winfrey. Oprah. Forrest Whitaker and the Civil Rights Movement.
Jake and Josh reference.
Guys, I have to tell you, you have to watch this movie, and you're going to cry in this movie. Especially if you're one for civil rights, and if you're a Democrat, you're going to love this movie. Anybody will love the movie, period, but you got to see this one. My number 1, Saving Mr. Banks, Walt Disney, P.L. Travers, Mary Poppins, Mickey Mouse. The making of the greatest achievement of Walt Disney is Mary Poppins. This movie is, I can't deny this movie, biggest picture of the year. It is amazing. It is monumental. It is a film for the ages. Kyle, I want to hear your list now.
My top 10 films is number 10, Gravity. Gravity, of course, it's Life of Pi in space, or
pretty much, yeah. It's
Life of Pi in space, or Space Hates Sandra Bullock.
You can rename the movie that, or just put the title there.
Number 9, The Lone Ranger. Wow, what a fun popcorn movie it was. Number 8, 42, with
But all you gotta know about that movie is Jackie Robinson. It's a biopic, but it's a great biopic.
All you Dodger fans out there will sure love this movie like I did.
And do not deny Harrison Ford. He was amazing. His best role in ages for this movie as Branch.
Yeah.
He disappears in the movie completely.
Number 7, Man of Steel. I love the old Superman movies, and I love how they took on... Mm-hmm. On Superman.
They really explained this very well. Very good adaption of this movie.
You didn't know it at first, the origin story of...
No, I didn't.
And this movie helped explain it, very
clearly understood, and Superman fans, I think, would be quite satisfied with this installment of the...
Even though a lot of Superman fans hated it.
We'll see about that.
Number 6, The Great Gatsby.
Leo DiCaprio.
Baz Luhrmann, I love you. You made another great one.
Mm-hmm.
Number 5, Frozen. At first I was skeptical with this movie. Yes. I had it high. I mean, The Lion King is easily one of my favorite movies of all time.
It's probably your favorite. Almost.
Yeah. But being compared to the best thing since Lion King, I mean, I'm like, whoa. And so, but the more I evaluate this movie, this is a great film. I love the movie. Number 4, Metallica, Through the Never. I'm a huge Metallica fan, and just seeing it put into
a narrative
perspective, and Dane DeHaan, the guy who played Trip in the movie, was fantastic. I mean, Metallica playing some of my favorite songs of all time, mm-hmm, just was incredible seeing. Number 3, Captain Phillips, Tom Hanks, what can I say? Or Barkhad Abdi. I mean, he just blew it out of the water. Number 2, Hunger Games, Catching Fire. They're pretty buff for being hungry. But it's a great film. I mean, Jennifer Lawrence just she hones her character well. And number one, Saving Mr. Banks.
Let's see how it goes.
I mean, you and I agree that this was a great film, and I mean, no other film from this year is going to top that movie.
You can't deny this movie Best Picture.
Yeah.
I mean, told you, as we finished watching it in the theater, how can this not win Best Picture at the Oscars?
Also, I'm not a believer of Colin Farrell, but wow.
He surprised the hell out of all of us.
He surprised me. I mean, he played that drunk, sympathetic man. Yes. I mean, you felt bad for him that he was going through the trouble and the genuine relationship he had with P.L. Travers. Mm-hmm. And you can see with that relationship why she was so hesitant to give Mary Poppins to Walt Disney.
Definitely. I mean, you have to see Mary Poppins first. If you haven't seen Mary Poppins, see that movie first, then see this movie, because it'll only add more depth and more emotion into seeing Saving Mr. Banks.
Yeah.
And really, this combination of these two movies is what Monsters, Inc. is to Monsters University. It works as, and actually, this movie pretty much has a great job of standing on its own without seeing Mary Poppins mm-hmm. at first.
But it does really help you. I mean, a lot of things like saying, I know where that's from, kind of thing.
It's always you in the theater. You can't stop singing. I gotta tell you, every time I see a movie with this guy, he doesn't shut up. But moving on.
I critique the movie. It's constructive.
When we were watching Monster University, he just stood up and applauded just for seeing the scare house.
Yeah, that was amazing.
There was this couple this young couple behind us. They were like, what the hell is this guy doing? And I was just like, I don't know him. So, yeah, that's Kyle. I want to talk about, you were really blown away with Hunger Games, were you? Let me tell you, Hunger Games, the first movie, was not in my top 10 list of last year. But man, this year
it just blew it sky high. I mean, I'm not I haven't read the books.
Obviously.
I haven't read the books, but this movie is just amazing. I mean, if you have not seen our review, go back to our
YouTube channel. Go watch it. We'll have a full analysis on that movie. It was just
YouTube
great.
Channel. I mean, it explains why.
But I want to talk about Frozen. Well, you saw it in San Diego, and what was your experience as you were walking into the theater and you saw that one? What was surrounding you and the awkwardness?
Half the theater was children. I mean, what do you expect? It's a G-rated movie.
And you were alone, by the way.
I was alone.
Not with me.
I was alone, not with you. And two soccer moms were sitting next to me. And I'm like this, okay. But I watched the movie, I'm like this, oh, come on. And I it's just, I don't know. I'm not a believer of that movie.
I saw Iron Man 3 in theaters with Antonio, with Giselle. And the one thing that couldn't get over their heads, it was Christmas all year long.
Yeah.
Iron Man 3. One more thing before we go, the Lone Ranger. Remember when we saw it with Antonio, there was this obnoxious guy in the front row. And
he would not stop laughing.
He was laughing at everything. We couldn't even understand.
A guy falls down. He laughs. A bird flies. He laughs.
It wasn't a giggle. It was like a loud as hell laugh.
Panoramic shot. He laughs.
Is this guy on something? Like, you know, the people we met in theaters that we had mm-hmm. this year long was just, wow. Guys, that was this year in cinema. Watch these movies and give us your top 10 list. Kyle, any last thoughts?
On Facebook, you know, on all the social media that we're on, and then you follow. And if you haven't follow us, please.
And like the Barely News crew on Facebook, YouTube, Instagram, and Twitter. We'll be right back with Top 20 Songs of 2013.